So, this is the black market. Let's hope I find some good games here. Ah, there must be one. Hello there.
Well, hello there. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for weird games that we cannot buy anymore in the store. Do you have any good ones, sir?
Ah, you are looking for old games. Here are some examples.
Those seem good games. How much are they?
You want to know the price? Well, they cost $80 per game.
So expensive.
Yeah, I know. Those old games are not a hit anymore.
Yeah, I can understand why, because we cannot buy them anymore, but...
But hey,
don't you have any more cheaper for a low reviewer like me?
I have something for you. Just for you. Here, take this apple.
Why did I get an apple?
Oh well, at least it is free. Better eat it up. Ah!
Where am I? This is not the black market. This is something different. Am I in a game or something? Oh no, it's gonna be one of those episodes, isn't it? Okay, I'm stuck here. So, it has to be one way to get out of this game. And I think it is by beating the game. Because that's basic of 101 when you are stuck in a video game. So, first off, I first need to know in what game I am in. Hey, there's someone. Maybe that person can help me. Hello? Are you there? Snow White! Is that you? You look horrible! What happened to you? Oh, okay then. Do you really need to tell about the history about your movie, Snow White? I think most people do. You're one of the first Disney animated movies in cinemas in 1937 by Walt Disney itself. But let's get that track aside and let's just focus on the game. So what do you need to do first, Snow White? You need to collect flowers. Why is that so in the castle, if I may ask? Okay. This is getting out of hand. Like, seriously, every time you want to speak, the music stops and you talk for like 2 words. Really? Just stop talking and collect your flowers, okay? I will go on to beat this game for you then. Yeah. Just moving on, girl, moving on. So, finally, now I can play the game, and I have to say, Snow White, please walk a bit faster. I know you are a little princess, and I know you walk in a dress, but at least walk a bit faster than I'm used to. Also, what is it with your animations? I don't know what it is, but it just doesn't work. Every time you jump, I cannot turn around, I have to make the jump. And every time I jump or fall down, I have to wait 4 seconds before I can walk again. And that all for collecting flowers. And this is the first level. And I have far more complaints to do. And this is only the first level. Like the environment what we are in. We are in the castle itself. Okay, what do we see in the castle? The huntsman. Okay, what do we see more? Again, the huntsman on a different location. Stairs that lead you elsewhere that makes no sense in the castle itself. Okay, the basement of the stepmother where she makes a poison apple.
Okay,
can we at least go to the next level, please? Oh wait, before we go into the next level, we have a little bit of an animation about it, or what I can recall it, little pictures that are really watered down. It's like somebody put water on top of it and you have to deal with it. Sure, it's on the Game Boy Color and it's for little kids, so I can understand that, but at least I can make it bigger so you can see it for yourself. If I want to show you guys how I played it, then Oh boy, what a tiny screen I had. Also, what I don't get is why is it so that with every new page, somebody has to end up the music and start almost all over again. That was no joke. It's really in the game and I cannot explain why that is. Maybe it was too much for the Game Boy Color, but otherwise I have no clue. Moving on with the second level. Oh, a minigame. Now, let's see what we can do with that. And done. Was it that difficult? Second level, we do the same thing as the first level, only then in a different location, and we have to collect butterflies. And you have to be in the right place to get it. Not one step away or one step backwards, no, on the specific spot where Snow White can collect it. If you don't, you waste your precious time do it again. And again. And again. And it's all collecting butterflies. Platforming a bit. And no enemies on screen. Yeah, didn't I tell you? There are no enemies on the screen when you do platforming and collecting stuff. No, only the collectibles you need to collect. A little bit of platforming. And if you mess up, you have to walk all the way back to get a second chance. It's not a backup plan, no. If you fall down, you have to walk back to the location where you did start off with the platforming. And this is just the second level, remember? And I see so many complaints so far. Okay, what's next on the list? A maze? Well, this is something different, at least different than the platforming. And there are enemies that can hurt you. The only problem is, it's clearly shown to you in which direction the enemies go, so the best thing what you can do is just wait or walk past it. Like, really, you can just walk beside him and he doesn't hit you. Okay then. And the end of it is all the way to the right. That's just easy. Just as normal maze, you'll walk this way and then this way and there we go. Next on the list is a second maze. Okay. A little bit longer, a bit more enemies, but doable. We are getting somewhere. Just taking my time and I have to wait. Okay. There we go. Now I can go. There we go. And wait. Okay. I can see it now. This is just about my patience in the maze. Is there not a different way I can go there? By the looks of it, no. So I just have to wait. Moving on to the next level then. Platforming again, and this time in the dwarf's home. Why do you ask? Well, that's because in the movie Snow White did clean it up with animal friends, and for that we have to find rabbits. And why do we have to find rabbits and not like, I don't know, something else that makes sense, like soap? Water? Anything else than animals that are bunnies? And what I don't get is why the bunnies are running away from you in the first place. So you have to be in the specific spot to catch it. And if the bunny runs away, too bad, try it again. Well, thanks game. And what I don't get is the platforming in here and the background. Because you have to be in the specific spot to jump on that platform. And if you mess up, you have to do it again. Good luck. And what I said with the background. How can be the dwarves be there in the first place? If Snow White can barely jump up there, how does the dwarves do that? Do they have a jump, double jump or something? Or do they work together? I don't know. But at least one thing is right in this level, and that's the seven bats that are in the movie. Wow, one thing that I praise about it. Next on the list is this minigame. What can I say about this minigame? Only that it's actually not finished yet. Because from all the plates that I have to collect, you have to be on a specific spot to get it. Not one step away or one step close. No, specific as usual. Not only if you collect the plate, you automatically go to the left side and then you have to walk all the way back to the middle. Not only is some of the animations weird, like the deer, because that deer is the only one that makes the plates disappear or come to you. But once again, if you collect a template, then you have to do it all over again until you have enough plates. But you don't know when. So, you are stuck here till you have beaten it or actually lost it. But this was an easy game, so I did easily beat it. So with that said, what's next on the list? Platforming again. The only difference is there is way more platforming in than normal. And there are some jump lilies, whatever they're called. Jump pads, I can say. That lets you jump higher than normal. But you'd never use it because otherwise you never get to the platform where you need to go. So, yeah. Oh yeah, and the collectibles are music notes because they want to have a music night. I think. What's next on the list? Simon Says. Okay, Simon Says. What can I say about this? Only then, it's a long minigame, like one of the longest. I like the music tones of it. The only problem is why it is so long. It took me this long to beat this minigame without any errors. If I did make one error in this minigame, then I had to do it all over again. So, good luck with that. Platforming again. And we are collecting apples. And why are we collecting apples, you might say? Well, that's because that old lady lost his apples and Snow White wants to help her. But that's literally all the poison apples that are described in the movie. So, Snow White is helping the witch to let herself killed.
Wow.
What is this for a minigame? This is by far a difficulty spike that I can never understand. It's like after Snow White is dead, or sleeping, whatever you want to call it, it suddenly gets difficult and you die a lot of this game. Not only because the hitbox are weird, not only that the deer animation is weird, but also of pitfalls. Lots of pitfalls. But it was easily done and the deer warned the dwarves that Snow White is sleeping or dead, depending how you look at it. And what do the dwarves do? Well, they collecting diamonds, because why not? And it was at this moment platforming became really a challenge for me, because you are smaller and you have to collect way more. And if you mess up with the platforming, you start all the way back at the beginning of the level almost. So, guess what I did for the next couple of minutes with this level. But I have to say, at least you have an action button to remove some stones away from you, but you can also jump on top of it. Okay. And you can just move around even though you are in the air with every single jump. Not that you are stuck with one single jump and you have to make the jump. You can go back. So that's good. Minigame. But this is the worst minigame of all. Because you have to kill 20 birds with one shiny stone. That takes 4 hits to kill one bird. And with every hit, you have to wait for a couple of seconds. But the biggest problem is, there's only one bird at a time, until you are in the halfway mark, and then you can kill 2 birds with one stone. I did not expect to say that, but moving on. Next platforming level, and this is finally the last platform level that I can say. We are collecting hearts, lots of it, platforming again. If you mess up, you have to all the way back. But now there's a challenge with this, because the hearts can fly away. And when they are flying away, you have to be off screen with them before you can go back and to collect it again. So, if you think you are with a white platform and the heart is going away, well, too bad. Jump off the platform and do the platform all over again in time. And you may think, oh, that's the end of the game because I said the last platforming. No, we have 2 more minigames to go to. One of them, I don't want to even talk about it because it's just collecting cards, memory, that is pretty challenging even for my standards, but then again, it's because of a small screen that I used. And then the last minigame in the game is Tetris. At least I think it is Tetris, but horrible. Horrible Tetris. Because only you can stack three things on top of each other. Not from left to right, right to left, no, from down to up. Nothing more, nothing less. And it will take some time before you beat it. But I did. Snow White is saved by the prince and they live happily ever after. And we are ending the game just like in the movies. What do I think about this game in all in the end? Well, to be honest, I think this game is a good guilty pleasure, for the least. It's a short game, took me around 50 minutes to beat. The only problem was some of the minigames were not done yet, you can clearly see that. Platforming is not all too difficult, it's just hideous where you need to go for the first time. But once you get used to it, then you have a good time. And as for the plot, well, it's one of the first animated Disney movies in 1937. What do you expect? Either way, it's a good little game for the meantime when you have nothing to do for the last couple of 50-60 minutes. But now I have to ask, how do I get out of here? Welcome back, sir. I didn't expect you to eat the apple, to be honest. It was supposed to be a game inside, but it looks like you eat the game as well. Whoopsie. And welcome to the end credits of this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. It really means a lot to me. I didn't expect this too many people will like my reviews, but by the looks of it, people still do. And I'm not going to quit it anytime soon. Right now I'm making on a new review, so until then, bye bye.